Maseches Bavabasa Daf Kuf Nun Amud Aleph. Yeah, we're in the middle of the page, but the two dots, that's exactly where we are. More about Shchiv Mera, may we live long. You know, they say if a person writes a will, it's a segula for long life.
Yeah.
So, yeah. Mm-hmm. So, too, maybe when you learn about Shchiv Mera, it's a segula, Bezos Hashem Tev Chaim Arukim, with no machlos and no bad things. Shita. Writers. This year's Lulu Nishmas of Emer Menachem Ben Akiva Rus Bas Shalom and Sara Bas Moshe and Yehudis Bas Moshe David Zeli. Pshita, with the two dots, which is two, the very end of the narrow lines, towards the end of the narrow lines, we have two dots, and then we have the word Pshita. Pshita, it is simple for us, it's understandable, it's simple, it's the axiom for us. Omar, if a person said, Metaltiloi Leplanya, my metaltilin, I'm on purpose, not exactly translating metaltilin. Usually I would say movable object, but here we're going to see that there are two levels of metaltilin. So metaltilin means things that can be moved around in general, meaning not real estate, but things that are movables, yeah? Mobile, it's a computer, it's the phone, it's the cup, it's the jacket, yeah? And let's say Eshchima said, metaltiloi leplanya, he said, all my metaltilin go to one person, to Mr. So-and-so. So then, what does it include? What does the word metaltilin include? What's included in metaltilin? And actually, Rashbam says that this sugi is not exclusively Shchiv Mera. It can also apply to a Kenyan. Let's say a person is 40 years old and he's jumping from the gym to the swimming pool, very healthy, and he wants to make a Kenyan. He wants to give all his metaltilin to one person and maybe leave something for himself. What does the word metaltilin include? So he means, kol mani tashmishte kani, all of his mani tashmishte, all the kalim that he uses are included in that. The cups, the pets, the pawns, the clothes, maybe things that are movable and used. Lebal, excluding michiti vesari. Yeah, but excluding what? He says, except for chiti vesari, except for wheat and barley, and I assume other foods as well. I don't know if chiti vesari is exclusive, or it means to say foods are not called metaltilin. As we know from Hilchas Mukze, food is not a kli. It could be better than kli, but food is not a kli. In other words, metaltilin, metaltilin alone would mean, he didn't say kol metaltilin, excuse me, that was a mistake. He said metaltilin. Metaltilin means more exclusive. The metaltilin themselves that are kalim. He didn't say kalim, but he said metaltilin. It means vessels, kalim, and not food that is perishable. Food is not a kli. Now, kol metaltilin. If he says all the metaltilin leplonio, if he says all of them, so that he comes to include more, he says all the metaltilin, that is, yeah, if he says the metaltilin, it means all of them, right? If he said my metaltilin go to someone, it's already inclusive. My metaltilin. If I say my children are nice, it means all my children, right? So if he says my metaltilin, I assume he means all of them. Elamai, there is some kind of exclusivity that he did not say kol. The fact that it says kol metaltilin is not adding more quantity, it adds another quality. Therefore, kol the metal, if he says kol metaltilin leplanya afilu chiti vesari. If he says all the metaltilin, that includes chiti vesari. Why? Of course, chiti vesari are not a kli, but they're movable. Chiti vesari can be moved around, right? You can take a sack of chita soiro, of wheat and barley, and move it about. It's not so against the nature of metaltilin. It's not a kli, but it's movable. It's not a house, right? Not only that, vafilu rechaim ha'elyoino, even the upper part of the millstone, you know, the millstone has two parts, the lower part and the upper part. The lower part, you barely ever move it. The upper part, if you have to fix it or clean it, as we all know, everyday life, yeah? So you move it, you take it off its hinge, off where it belongs, and give it a clean, or you give it a, whatever, some kind of fixing up. That's a lioino that is still called movable, only if you said kol metaltiloi. So all is that is included in the sale. But the lower millstone, the lower part of the millstone, which is bigger, heavier, and is hardly moved around. You can move it around, but you hardly ever move it around. Say honestly, when was the last time you moved your fridge? Erev Pesach, maybe once more. You can move your fridge. right? You can move your fridge, but how often do you move it? So the Rucham HaTachton is like that. It's something that you can move, but you hardly ever do. I'll hear your questions in a second. So that is kol mitalteli. Kol mitalteli, all those that are sometimes moved, chiti, soiro, and the upper rechaim. But the lower rechaim is not usually moved. It can be, but usually it's not. Now we're going to talk about the third level. If it says kol de metaltel, kol de metaltel means anything that can be moved, not anything that is usually moved, anything that can be moved, kol de metaltel, afilo chaim etachtoi no kani. Even the lower chaim, which can be moved, yes, they can be moved. You call Arnold and you together, you move it together with him, Arnold and Mike, together, they move it, yeah, and they move it when you have to clean it. Otherwise, no. And those things is included in kol de metalteli because it can be moved. Yep. What did you want to ask?
In those days, when you got the
mic recorded. I think the next level up, which will never be included in metalteli sale, is something screwed to the ground. The rechaim ha-techtonos are very heavy, not designed to be moved, except for once a year when you make Pesach, like your very, very big, heavy fridge. Yeah, you move it once in a while. But you can move it. Meshe'en can, something that cannot, that is already attached to the ground physically with screws, even if it's not the strongest screws, I do not think it's metalteli. No, I think that's gufa. That's where we already draw the line. Kach nireh. Shlomo made a good point that I was thinking also, chiti v'sari, as opposed to tomatoes and cucumbers, are inventory. It's something you keep in your store. Yeah, inventory. Okay, whatever. Yeah. In other words, the chiti v'sari, okay, the chiti v'sari are things that you keep in your store. So that's a chiddush. It's not something that you eat all the time. Even that is not included in metaltelin unless you specify kol metaltelin. Very nice. Let's continue. Now we're talking more about avodi. Yeah. Welcome. We're in the second wide line, the third wide line. Ibailu, there was a question, besmedrash, third wide line. Avdo, ano avdo de kutsha brichu. And Eved Knaini, kemekarka or kemetaltela dami? Is an Eved considered like karka or like metaltelin? How yeshivish are you? Let me tell you a small story, very personal story, expose, unbelievable, get all the media. Yeah, that once I told a bunch of Chiloni students, I told them, you know, the night starts from the day starts from the night. Yeah, in other words, for us, Leil Yom Sheni is all Yom Sheni. So they told me, for you now is Monday? I said, yeah, it's Monday. This was Sunday night. I said, for me, it's Monday because it's Leil. Yeah, that's how Leil Shabbos works. Bereshis, Ve'erevi Boiker. So they said, very nice. And like half a minute afterwards, I said, okay, guys, now it's Sunday. They caught me on the act, yeah? In other words, I spoke like a regular not lefi derech ha-toyra. We still see Sunday night as Sunday. That's his derech ha-olam. We call it Sunday night. Yeah, and that's how the calendar works. V'chule. So that's exactly the same question over here. An Eved, is an Eved considered as karka or metaltelin? Meaning, according to the Torah, an Eved is considered as karka. You buy and sell the Eved as if he was a karka, kesef, shtar, and chazoko, and not with cash. Let's say you can't buy Eved with cash. You have to pay cash as just to pay off the debt that you owe, yeah, the payment. But the actual transaction is kesef, shtar, and chazoko. Excuse me, you do buy with kesef, excuse me. You buy him with kesef, shtar, chazoko. You can't buy him with a meshich or a gbo, I meant to say, which is also a shayla, some people who say it, nechon. Conceptually, you buy him like a karka with kesef, shtar, and chazoko. Shvua, you can't make shvua on Eved or in karka. Yeah, you can't swear this karka is mine. That's there's a kosuf. Why? It says v'snachatim oisom libnechem achareichem. You have to bequeath it like a nachla, just like regular nachla in the Torah means land, piece of land. So too, the eved is like considered halachically, that for halachic reasons is considered as if it was land. Now, on the other hand, he does move around. The eved is more metaltel than metaltel. He's more metaltel than the cop. The cop, last time I checked, can't move on his own. And then eved... Eved can move by his own volition. Yeah, so we may learn
that one. If he's a very good Eved, very good.
Exactly, a good Eved moves around and he runs around very good with a basket on his head. So the Mekarki, oh, with the metaltelin, that's a question. When a regular Joshmo Jewish guy, nice Jewish boy, says, I'm giving you my metaltelin, did he mean Eved? Yeah, or when he says Mekarke, did he mean Eved? What, yeah, where does Eved belong in those two sections, Metatili or Mekarke? Who is he like? Amal Ravacha Breid Rav Avi El Rav Ashi. Here, I'll prove it to you from a Mishnah that we've seen long, long time ago, Gud Chazorah. What does it say there? Toshma, it says in the Mishnah, Hamoicher Sa'ir, a person actually owns the entire town. Yeah, he's the owner of the city. He's not just a mayor, he actually owns the city. Yeah, people back then used to own cities. Yeah, we not even that long ago, maybe today, some places. Yeah, we discussed all sugya. So a person tells you, I'm selling you the entire city that belongs to me. So what's included in the city? Mocha, botim, so all the real estate stuff that's mechuba lekarka is included. Mocha, batim, the houses are included. Shichin, umeorois, all types of cavities in the ground. The shiach is like a trench. Meoro is the cave inside. Umechatzo is also the merchatz, beis merchatz, the bathhouse. Ubeis abadin, yeah, beis abadin are the press, the olive press, oil press. Ubeis shlochin, also the fields that are near the city, they're in the municipal area of the city, all these aval, what's not included? Avaloyes and metaltilin, but metaltilin are not included. All kinds of movable objects, they're not part of the ir. Ir means the actual city, as you know, when you start playing these games like Monopoly or these games, you know, the basics, not an example. The basic is the city. Yeah, then you fill it in with other stuff. Yeah, all the movable stuff, the movable things, are not considered as the ir itself. That's how we view Das Bnei Odom. Ubizman she'omar, however, when he said, Hu v'chol ma she'besoicho, again, if he included and he said the city and everything that's in it, he added the words, not only the city, but kol ma she'besoicho, everything that's in the city, then afilo ha'yuba behema, even if it has in it, behema, it has animals running around and they're always there in the city. This cow is a citizen of whatever, Beth Shemesh, of that place. Oy avodim, or you have avodim, Haray kulan mechurin, they are all included. You said avodim, the avodim are included. If you said what, v'chol ma shebesoicho. So you see in the Reisha, we spoke about things that are mekarka. We spoke about the bathhouse, we spoke about the field, we spoke about the trenches, we spoke about all kinds of interesting nichse delonaidi, all kinds of things in the part of the karka. Yeah, the seifa sounded like we're adding more things that are lichora not part of the karka, such as animals, the behema. Right? Oy avodim. Ah, so what does that sound like? Is eved lekarka or like metaltelin? But he's not included in them. It says if he just says the ir, then all mechubar lekarka is included. I'm selling in the city, that means everything that is part of the land, all the other real estate. But if you added v'chol ma shebesoicho, then and only then the avodim and the animals are included. Mashma lechoyra, the avodim is not mechubar lekarka. We see it does not belong to the first list of all these things that are part of the karka. In Hebrew, we have an expression, part of the furniture. It's like a person has been there for the past 30 years. You go to an office and you see the same guy there 30 years, the same person in the same corner, and the same thing, same thing. He's part of the furniture. So here, he doesn't look like the slave is chelek mariut. He looks like some mayors, they say. A mayor is like, you know, in Israel, sometimes mayors can stay like 40 years on their throne, the chelek mariut also. So then, kulan mechurin, but you see the choira, says the Gemara, I omat bishlam ki metaltili dami. If you say that the Eved is considered as metaltilin, I'm not going to translate that again. Mishum hachi, that's why loy mizdaben bereisha is not sold alongside with the other items of the reisha. The reisha seems to be a very exclusive list of mechuba lakaka, the ground, the chol mash kosher to the ground, and the Eved is not there. Ela yomad biki mekarka edami. But if you want to tell me that the Eved is mekarka, you want to tell me an Eved is like halachically when it comes to sale. I'm not talking halachically. This is Bedas Bnei Odom. That's not what the Torah decided. When people talk to each other, one city owner goes to another millionaire, another oligarch, selling him the city, that's Bederach Bnei Odom. And there too, what do we say? Iki mekarka edami. You want to tell me like a piece of land, then a milam is done. Followed with the first list. Why isn't it included with them, right? Because if that's the way people talk, Elama, you see, no. You see, when people talk to each other, they look at reality and they don't look bidyuk the way the Torah looks at it. When I spoke to those students, I didn't say, today is Monday. I said Sunday, because we look at Sunday night like Sunday, unfortunately, maybe, but that's the way it is. So you see, the Balabatish mind works better here. That seems to be the guideline. So an Eved is like a metaltelin. Says the Gemara, are you sure? Is that so? The Ela, if so, my, what do you want to say? The Gemara now wants to refute that proof. The Gemara wants to reject that attempt to prove. The Ela, my, ke metaltel dami. You want to tell me an Eved is a pure metaltelin? People don't exactly look at the yeshiva shalom dish away. They talk normal, as we say. You want to say, metaltelin, because Eved moves around. Is that so? Still, there's a red herring here, and there's an issue. My afilu. What does it say, even an Eved? What does it say, afilu an Eved? Even an Eved, and even a behema. Behema? A behema is for sure metaltelin. Behema was never compared to karka. So why do you say even behema and avodim are considered like metaltelin? If they're clearly, purely metaltelin, why do you have to say even? When you say about somebody, when you want to say about somebody even, it's a chiddush. It's a chiddush. Even him. Yeah, a guy who's there, you know, a guy who's barely frum. He said, even he learns an hour a day. Kolshek and you should. Yeah, even the guy, even. That's all vort of afilu. So what do you say? Afilu meant what? That lechoira, it's not so simple that the Eved and even the behema, but the Eved, you can say, why it's afilu? Because the Torah looks at him like karka. What about animal? There's some kind of subtext here that we have to understand. Ela ma'islach lemeima. You know why do we bechlal look at the avodim and the animals with a different kind of look, with a different perspective? Shiny metaltel denayad, metaltelin that nayad. That's the nayad. What is it called? Nayad moves around, mobile. That's called nayad. You know that, yeah? Why metaltelin move around? That's actually not nayad. Metaltelin that can move on their own volition by themselves are different from metaltelin de lo nayad. Metaltelin that do not move, like the phone, like the cup, they may be different. Ah, that's a vort. It has nothing to do with karka or with metaltelin. One could argue that things that move around, that eved, if it feels like it, some nice guys from the north are going to help him. He can move around. The cat and the cow, they can move to a different city. One would argue that regardless of their status as mekarkin or metaltelin, maybe when you have things that move around, they're not part of the city, right? Because they can move. They can move out. Nachon, they have their own moyach and their own will and all willing to risk their lives maybe. Slaves used to run away all the time in Rome also, the Caesar, yeah? So if so, afilu temekim karkei dami, then even if you say that usually could be, you'd be made of the proof is gone out the window. Because even if you tell me David is mekarkei, shine mekarkei denied me mekarkei delo nayed. Even if you want to tell me that the Eved is really, maybe usually when people talk about what? About mekarkei. A person tells the other friend, his friend, I'm selling you all my lands. Maybe he means an Eved, because lands means an Eved. I'm selling you all my lands. He has one land in Netanya, and he has one land in Be'er Sheva, and he has two avodim. He's a very yeshivish guy, and everyone talks toiredik, like yeshivish, and they all mean kalkos or avodim. Could be. I'm not proving it, but could be. Are you talking about that Mishnah? No. There the person did not specify karka. He didn't specify what? He didn't specify non-karka. He said the city, everything that's in the city. I would not say that avodim are included because they happen to be able to walk, and also the cows and also the cats, even their own by people. How many times people lose dogs? I'm not in the dogs bechlal. Yeah, they go. The cow, they get lost all the time. Even in the Torah, kita chamor, they get lost. They go around. They walk around. Mimela, they're not approved. Could be in a general sale. They're not included in the general thing of everything in the city. That's why afilu. Don't bring me proof from over there. Here, when I specify my karkos, I mean all my karkos, including that. Maybe no. We didn't prove that, but we're still on the question. Yeah, you can't prove from that Mishnah either way, because that Mishnah is out of the box, out of the story. It's a general Mishnah about selling a city. Yes, Rabbeinu. Rabbi Goyen, what do you say? I apologize, my examples are sometimes too dramatic and maybe melodramatic. No, I don't mean because they run away, even if they can't run away, but conceptually they can. In other words, things that move around are not conceptually the some part of the city. So I would say, Unless it says Zuchol Mashu B'Soicha. Even if this dog didn't run away for the past 10 years, very loyal, and the cow is very lazy, lo mishane, or this Eved is very loyal and very scared, lo chpatlis, I'm not saying because he, exactly, I'm not saying he will move. The mere fact that those things have two legs and the ability to move around, I would say things that move around are not part of the Rihut. They're not Rihut. They can move. It's not because, yeah, so even if he has a chip, and that it's a conceptual thing, it's not a practical thing. Yeah. Now, so we still are in search. We're still searching for the proof. The person talks to his friend and he says, "I'm selling you my land." Does it include the avodim? Or when he says metaltalin, does that include the avodim? Or maybe both? You can also say both. That's still a question. How do people talk? Lefi the Torah or lefi what seems to be the everyday reality, the metzias? Toshma, a koisev, and this is chazora on what we did the previous Amud on Thursday. Toshma Koisev, we have the brackets here. We are about 5-6 lines from the bottom of the page with Kol Nechosov in parentheses. Akoisev Le'avdoi Kol Nechosov. I don't know, it's in parentheses. A person who wrote all his Nechosim to his Eved. He had a very loyal Eved, Givaldi Eved. And on his deathbed, he even writes, like a Tzavo, you can Tzavo Shchiv Mera. And he says, "I'm giving all my money to who? All my nechosim." That's a question. What's included? Is it? I know it's the parentheses now. Right. Kol kakois. Sorry. Kol nechosov la'avdoi. He wrote all the nechosim to his slave. My slave, he will be the one who will own all my nechosim.
Including himself.
Because you cannot, if he remains an eved, then he can't own anything. Mashakono eved, kono raboi. As opposed to a woman, by the way, if a feminist asks you, Mashakono eved, kono raboi, Mashakono so isha, kono bailo, no. Isha, konso isha, konso bailo has about easier, can give you like 5 exceptions and maybe 10. Yeah, lots and lots of exceptions. A married woman can own money many, many times. An eved, there are no exceptions, as far as I know, but as far as I know, yeah, Masha kono eved, kono rabbi. Once the eved acquires it, automatically it's already by the headquarters. It's owned by its owner, his owner, sorry. So mimeila, now, if you say all my assets go to my eved, you're saying 2 for the price of 1. He will get everything, as you said, including himself. I'm basically freeing the eved. I want to answer your question again because I'm giving you the COVID that you happen to miss the shir, and I'm sorry about the phone. So Baruch asks the question: the person is doing an avera because tamazo and eved knaini should not be freed, and if you do it, you're over an asay. It says lo oilam behem tavoidu, which means you should always subjugate the avodim knaini. It's not a good thing to have an eved meshucha. Yeah, for various reasons, the Torah doesn't like it. And therefore, we say the Eved should stay in Eved. He did an Avera. My answer is, you know, there are lots of people in Tel Aviv who wear pants, women. Yeah, people do Averas. I know you live in a very failing... In other words, some Averas work with the Eved. Like a coin marrying a Grusha. Is she an Eshetish? Yes. In other words, it's a kind of Avera which is only, Chalila, not to be Mezalzel, it's only breaking an Aseh. It's not a chorus that doesn't work, yeah? It works if a person is freed his slave, so even not for a good reason. So Bedi'evid, it works. Nobody recommends it. This is Bedi'evid, yeah? So it happened to be that way. Sometimes it's mutter for Dvar Mitzvah, for Tzoch Godol, for Priya Veriva, it's half, all kinds of other mitzvahim. But even if you did it Be'isur, Bedi'evid, it works because it's not an Isur chorus, it's only breaking Ma'aseh. Okay? So that's the answer to your question. So Yotzu ben Choirin, if he says, all my nechosim go to my Eved, Eved goes scot-free, because he's included. Now, Shir Karka Kol Shehu, Lo Yotzu ben Choirin. I want to check again, because I remember from...
Lost Lev?
No, 1 second. Okay, lo mishane. Okay. Shir Karka Kol Shehu, Lo Yotzu ben Choirin. If he says... 1 second. I'm giving all my nechosim to my dear Eved, except for a karka. It didn't say which karka. He said, except for one karka, then the Eved is not free. Why? Because we can automatically assume that he is that piece of land. In other words, yeah, that's what we said last time too. It's about the third time we're seeing this. In other words, if you say, maybe you are the karka. You are the karka, mister. He comes to Beis Din, doesn't say, he said, except for one piece of karka. Well, mister, you are the karka. Because he didn't say except for a karka. If he said all menachosim go to the eved except from a piece of land in Mazkeret Batya, I don't know, 1 kilometer over 1 kilometer in some place, and he says except for that, then according to Tanakama, the eved is free. Except the dead goes to the ocean. But if he says, except for a karka, very mysterious, enigmatic, which a karka, which maybe him, maybe it's Eved, could be Baruch also, we don't want him to be over the Avera. Maybe that's what we assume that way. Choliot, I'm thinking now. We prefer not assuming he's Meshucho. Yeah, but therefore we say, if he says a piece of karka stays behind, then we say, hey, hey, you are the piece of karka. You, why not? We assume that. What's, prove to me otherwise. Prove to me otherwise, said the Yoshim to the Eved. Hey, hey, they're fighting in Beis Din. And therefore, we say, we don't know, we assume that piece of land could be him, because it's called a piece of land. So far, Lichoyro, although we're going to change very soon, we see so far that when people write Karka, they mean Eved. Lichoyro, right? We're moving towards the side that Eved means Karka, but that's going to change very quickly. But, let me read one more opinion, and then I'll hear your opinions. Give some cover to Rab Shimon. Rab Shimon says, no, lo'olam ben choirin. He's always considered a ben choirin, even if a piece of karka is left behind, we still assume that he is a free man. And she'yama kol nechosai, all my assets. Asset is a very big word. Asset could be karka, metaltelin, eved, UFO, nechosim, or any asset. Unless he says, kol nechosai netunin leploini avdi, if he says, all my assets are giving to ploini, my eved, chutz me'echad meriboy shabahen. If he says, one riboy, I don't know why dafka this, one riboy is like one from riboy, one from 10,000, then we say that the Eved is not included. The Eved is called Echad Miriboy. If we're talking in numbers, that is a wider definition, Nechosim, numbers, then we say that the Eved is left behind. But if he says, except for Karka, then we say, no, the person means Karka, dirt, ground, something arable, he didn't mean the land. That's Shimon, but that's Rab Shimon. Okay, yes. Yes, Lachkor. Pause and referring to Moshe's first question. When the Torah says an Eved is bought like a acquired like a karka, and the Eved, there's no shvu on him like a karka, does that mean that the Torah said, he's karka? That's it. The Torah views him as karka for all intents and purposes. And that's it. Mimela, I could say, people also, when they say karka, they mean an Eved. It's entrenched in their minds. Eved is karka. Or do we say no? Eved really is metaltelin. The Torah gave that metaltelin a few features like karka. That's another way. But there are two ways. Yeah, a lamdan appreciates two different ways. Instead of, I'm saying, of hooking onto one, the two tzdodim. That's a good lamda shechakira. Weiter. So now, the Omer of Dimi, four lines from the bottom of the page. The Omer of Dimi, Bar Yosef, Omer Bielozo, also metaltilin shir etzel eved. Stop mid sentence. Now comes in the Moiro of Dimi, Bar Yosef, and he says, even according to Tanakama, metaltilin are the same lakaka when it comes to an eved. Ah, unlike metaltilin are shir etzel eved, which means even if the person said, I'm leaving behind metaltelin, not karka, it also excludes the Eved, possibly. In other words, an Eved can be either, an Eved can play both fields, both be in both boxes. If either he said karka, then the Eved can be left behind and not be the owner, and not be a free man. Or even if he said metaltelin is the same, karka is only an example brought down. Remember why? Soon we'll see, because let's continue. Veloy also, he belongs to two boxes. Veloy also metatilin shiu etzel ksuba. Meshenken beksuba it's not. Which means, let's say a lady was told before her husband's death, or even way before, he told her, hey, darling, you're a big girl, I'm giving you a piece of land like a yoreshes. Pshia, you get the status of a yoreshes. You can now write to everyone in your whatever, in social media, I'm a landowner, pshia, even though I'm a woman. And what? And you're not getting, oh, we assume she's giving up her ksuba. If she kept quiet and happy about it, so that, nachon, yeah, chazor is a good thing. So then, even if it's less, psh, very good. Even if it's less, she still prefers the kovet over the money. She doesn't have to beg them all the time for the ksuba and have fights with her kids or her stepchildren. She has her own land. She prefers, you know, tov pas chareve v'shal v'bo, mi bais mo leziv cheriv. She prefers a little bit of land, more kovet, more status, more normality than than having to go to get the ksuba. That's the assumption. You can argue otherwise, but that's what Chachamim decided. In that case, metaltalin won't work. If you tell a woman you're getting metaltalin, yeah, you get a room full of shoeboxes with shoes inside, even expensive. No, as much as she likes the shoes, she's not going to give up her ksuba for that. Why? My time. My time. Why is that? Avda metaltelu, metaltelu, metaltelu havishil, which means when we spoke about an eved and a person says to his eved, Mr. Eved, you own everything except for metaltelin. Except for some metaltelin, didn't say which. Maybe it's the eved, because you know what eved is metaltelin. Eved is opposed to what the Torah says, or like Moshe said, it's not even opposed to the Torah. Even the Torah doesn't say it's completely like a kalka. And eved is in between; it belongs in both camps. Which passport do you have? American and Israeli. Vosnish kastira. All very good, right? Both. Yeah, nice, good, fine. So Mimela, what the Eved is metaltelin and karka. So when I say except for metaltelin, huh? It may mean except for you, Mr. Eved, and you remain an Eved, and you'll now be enslaved by the children, and you own nothing. Mashain ken uksubas ishak mekalkahu. Ksuba, a woman, when she collects her ksuba only from karka. If the man has no cash, even with cash, the kids, when they're left behind with karka, automatically her ksuba is collected from karka. We're not learning ksubas now, but karka is most by the chov, there's Somach on karka more than metaltelin, right? The smichus das of a woman is if he has a karka.
When she gets the boss, who's going to make it the tea? We'll have to check some clay.
No, you're mixing the two cases. No. There's no evidence in the case of the woman. We're just saying metaltelin by the case of a woman. If you left her behind metaltelin, then we say, then she's not giving the ksuba. We're not stupid. She says, no, I still want ksuba with security of the land rather than metaltelin, which can burn tomorrow in the storage room. So mimeilu metaltelin mekalka ilav ishiu, that's chalk and cheese. I mean, apples and oranges. Yeah, he left behind metaltelin that doesn't help her shibud karka, which is stronger for ksuba. But in any event, don't let this whole storm mystify you. One thing we see from here, we see from here that the eved is definitely called metaltelin. At least, no, in Goloshen bnei Adam. I don't care if it's a shiu or if it's a shiu without an ayin. Shiu was leaving behind, or I don't care if it's a kinyan, or I don't care if it's writing a children's story. Lemaise, when people talk about eved, they talk metaltelin. And even the Mishnah that said karka, even that Mishnah, the Amoraim said, it also means metaltelin. Remember what the Gemara said? We chose the Loshen karka because of stylistic reasons, because the following Mishnah there in Peah, spoke about karka, the small piece of karka that was last year. A small piece of karka, you can write, you can have peya and bikurim, v'chule, v'chule. So we spoke about karkois, but really, it's a big, 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 big lav dafka. And a chinami, and eved, beloshen b'nei adam, can be considered as a North Korean, can be considered as metaltelin. That's what we say. So mimeila, don't prove b'chlal that it's karka. Omale, now comes the answer, and then you can ask good questions. Now we come with a whole new world, a whole new aspect about an Eved. Anan, why we say that the Eved, as long as metaltelin are left behind, the Eved is left behind too? It's not because the Eved is metaltelin, it's because the Eved is not an exclusive owner of everything. So what? Mishum delav krois gita mesninan lo. It's not Sefer Krisus, don't laugh. Which means we all know that by woman it says Venosan Beyoda Sefer Krisus, which means if a man, forget about the abusive sound of it, if a man tells his wife, yeah, this is your get, on condition that every day until the end of your life, you have to come to me at 10 o'clock and serve me tea or do something. She's not migoreshes. Why? Because it's not get Krisus. A get that binds them for life is not a get. A get has to be a clear cut off point. There's me and her, and we finish the story. If he tells her, you may raise an eyebrow, start asking me that. I didn't say like that. All the cases of Tnoim we had is one clear Tnoim. In other words, if he says to her, this is your get, and if in 2 years' time, in Rosh Chodesh Kislev, there will still be Corona, it's going to rain in London, in 2 years' time, then immigrations, otherwise, no, that is a good get. Why? Because in 2 years' time, it will rain in London, Emirates Hashem, then she's cut off. That's okay. It's one clear Tnoim, then even after the death, we say, like those who went out to Mechemes Bezdov, like Becheva. But if he has a tonight that binds, that's the word, that binds her to him all the time, it's not krisus. It's not krisus. Krisus means to sever. Lichrot, in proper English, to sever. To sever, yeah? To sever in a severe way. Lichrot yad, rak regat avaksha. Same thing with an eved. Pam, pam, pam. An eved, you should always know, as opposed to any other thing that a person may own, be it enel, be it metatolin, an eved has two aspects to him. A, he's owned monetarily, and even if the eved was bought off you to another person or somebody wants to free him, forget about the Easter, yeah? You also need to get from the owner. A get, in a way, absolutely. There's a whole story of an eved being cut off like a get. Aha, so now the story is as follows. Forget about the eved being called metaltalin or karka, or is it called the UFO from Corona land? Loch patli, how you call him. The mere fact, hama mishachar the eved by giving him all the money. So if I say you own all the money, except for a piece of land, who owns a piece of land? The owner or his children. We've joined. We are still not karut, we're not cut off. The way the eved and the owner are still connected by some kind of business. Let's say Bemis, we would work for the eved, and he owns 90% or 95%, but the original owner of the eved owns 5%, that alone makes it, and he's still bound by him. It's not like he was a free man, and after he was free, then I joined his business. That's fine. He never really got 100% free. If he only owns 95%, he's 95% free, because I, the owner, I'm still owning part of his, what he owns too. We are connected. That's not krisus. It's not enough of, it's not called that we severed the ties. And that is a problem. So Mimeli doesn't reflect at all about the eved being called kark, being called metaltalin, calling whatever you want. The mere fact that there's still some kind of ownership is a zaitadika problem. It's a side thing, but it's a very important side thing. It's not karut. And therefore we say that that's the issue. Mimeli, you can't reflect on anything. No, he was first for sure. I promise you, there's no discrimination. Fine. Amar Rav Amar Nachman, a new statement, which is really a nice summary of a lot of things we've been learning in the past few weeks. We are in Kuf Nun Amud Beis, Bama Basra Kuf Nun Amud Beis, in the second line from the top of the page. Bezal Hashem. Amar Rav Amar Nachman, Chamisha, there are five cases, not five people, five cases of Kinyan, of Matano actually. Ad shiichtu v'kol nichsein. The five types of matonas that only work, so to speak, if you write everything and you didn't leave one thing behind. Give me one example, but quick. Everyone should know one example. Oh. For who? No. In which case? Dead, live, maybe? So? No. Shchinah. That said, I'm giving you 95% of my nechosim, and he left behind a nice, cute little apartment they can live off. And then he sprung back to life, a new lease on life, mazel tov, yeah. Then what? Do we say, what? Then he's not choizer, because something is, you meant the right way. In other words, as long as he has something small with him, not choizer, you kept that egg in the basket for yourself in case you stay alive, yeah. He wants to place the bets. Only if you gave everything, there are exceptions to that rule too, but let's say there's one guy, he gave everything to one guy, and then jumping out of bed and he's healthy again. Then he says, excuse me, monsieur, give me back everything because I didn't have a das to stay alive, and be penniless with zero. Now, that's one example, but you know, Shchimer has four friends. That's Shchimer group. Yeah, come invest with us. Yeah, so he has five different cases. Another four cases that, in that respect, similar to Shchimera, most of them, meaning four out of those five, we already learned. It's Chazara, and there's a fifth case called Borachas, the woman, or Mavrachas. Let's see. Velen Shchimera, Avdoi, the slave, Ishtoi, yeah, his wife, Ubonov, his children, Umavrachas. Don't worry, we're going to Mavrachas. Mavrachas Nechosav, that will be tomorrow. No. It's a woman. It's Mavricha. Shchivmera, we know. He's a good friend. That's case number one, where there's a big difference between all or 95%. Shchivmera, Detnan. Shchivmera, Shekosov, Kol Nechosov, Lacherim. Shchivmera wrote off all his assets to other people. Veshir Kaka Kolshu. He left behind a small piece of land, which we discussed maybe what? It's a Mechloikes. Whether it means kolshu, or means something substantial to live off, right? But nasoi kayemes, if he left himself something nice on the side, and then he's back to life, okay, your matana still remains a matana, and the other 90% of nechasim stay in the hands of the mekabel, of the recipient. But if he did not leave anything to himself, any piece of land, we had a shiloh but metaltelin. Leave that alone. But let's say all he has is kalkois, and he did not leave any kaka to himself. And matnasa kayemes, a matana is not a matana. Avdoi, what about the eved? Oh, we're going to see it yet again. Second case, eved, did none. A case of kol nechosav la'avdoi yotzei ben choirin. He wrote each and every neches, everything he owns, the swimming pool and the old plantation and the cotton field, whatever, everything is owned by the eved, then yotzei ben choirin is a ben choirin. Could be the children will have to give him a get, by the way. I'm not sure, but I think so, yeah. Or maybe the death of the odon, I think it's a shayla and git, and I think if the death of the odon is good enough, like a husband dying so his wife is free, or I don't know. But l'maisa, the eved is free. I gave him each and every granule that I own, every dollar in the account, then avada is no krisus, he owns everything, including himself. Mashenka and shir karka kol shu, and maybe also metaltalin, nachon? We said karka or metaltalin. You left something to yourself or your heirs. Lo yotze ben choirin. Yeah, you can't be a little bit pregnant. Something, you can't be a little bit. It's all or nothing. Sometimes we're extreme. We are b'chemish extremists. Yeah, in other words, then what? Lo yotze ben choirin. Something still owned by the odon. You're not out of the binding relationship. Then he's not out. Third case, ishtoi. We saw that in Daf Kuflam and something about 20 dafim ago. A person wrote all his assets to his wife. His children are there, gaping, better than any soap. All the children by the temple, mother got everything and they got nothing? No, look, cannot be. We assume a person will not write everything to his wife and leave the children completely penniless. Unless he says mefurish, that's what he means. We don't interpret his words that way. So what's he writing? What's he doing? I'm sure now you remember. He made her the executor, right? Not an executor. He doesn't want him to kill her. Yeah, executor, which means custodian. In other words, he wants her to run the show, so they should give her COVID. Give cover to the mother. Unfortunately, if she's a stepmother, bechlal, even their own mother, kids can be less mechubad, even in times of the Gemara, the halacha knows about everything. And therefore, he wants her to have the status of the person in charge of the tzava, and that's what he meant. He didn't mean you own everything, you're in charge of everything. You hold it, you know, you hold the keys in your hands, you hold the helm, and they should all come and be nice to you because they know you run the show. Aye, but if he left something to his children and gave her most of the things, then we say, no, he meant to give her most of the thing and the rest he left to the children. Again, we can play with the numbers, but kikaron, if he says, hey, darling, my dear wife of the past 70 years, I'm giving you, you're great, and I'm giving you, let's say, 80%. Wow, that's a big wow. And everyone's, but 80% and 20% goes to the children. Then he means 80% because he left them something substantial. But if he gave her everything, then we say that's too bizarre. So we interpret his words as her being the executor and not being the owner, right? So they should give her covered. We had discussions, questions before the death, v'chulei. Bonov, fourth case, fourth out of five. The Tnan, a case of kon chosav lebonov, and we saw that also recently. We saw it actually a few minutes ago. A person wrote all the nechosim to his children. He's now dividing in a very dramatic moment. He's calling them, dividing all the nechosim to the different children. You get the swimming pool, you get the tennis court, and you get the thing. The cost of l'ishto karka kolshu, he wrote his wife a small piece of land, even smaller than a ksuba, ibda ksuba, so she lost her ksuba. Unless she protested quickly, or upon hearing it, but if she's like, okay, she kept serving the coffee and says, oh, I think that's very cute, or she didn't say anything, but she's like, shtike koido. If she seems to be okay with having a small piece of land, but the status is like a proper landowner, as opposed to somebody who has to ask for a ksuba and beg for it and start fighting, she has proper piece of land. Yeah, every English person knows the statement. Yeah, mejor un pájaro en mano que diez volando. You know what that means, right? No, it's not. It means it's better to have one a bird in the hand than 10 flying. No. I'm unfortunate. Wait, Mashenken, if there's something left that is not given to any of them, not to her and not to them. Yeah. A small piece of land that she can collect her ksuba from. I forgot the main thing. Where do we have the all or nothing here? One second, sweet. Let's say the person wrote to them 80% and to her 10%. And there's still 10% left for her to write, to get her ksuba from. Then she didn't give up her ksuba. If she sees that she only gets a piece of land and she sees, hey, there's no karka to get meksuba from, then she chaps, the asimon nafal, she chaps what's going on. She says, hey, that's instead of meksuba. And she still kept quiet. Mashma, she prefers that maslul rather than the other, right? Mashainkin, if you left her a piece of land to the yoshim free, it doesn't belong to one yoshim's matono, and not to her either. There's one piece of land that she can collect the ksuba from, then we say, no, she did not give up her ksuba. She still wants the ksuba from the other field. And that's the difference between all or nothing. And the shir is over. Mavrachas is the fifth case, which we'll see tomorrow. Don't run away. Ha, ha, ha. Mavrachas, we'll see what that means. And that's the fifth case, which we didn't yet learn, about all or nothing. Thank you very much. Yeah, there's a question now.